Hey there, Foundation staff! Sherm here, and welcome to Sherm's Declassified Skip Survival Guide. Today we are covering one of the most requested topics in SCP lore, a comprehensive breakdown of everything we know about the Scarlet King. Remember one of the most important laws of the SCP wiki, there is no canon. So we're going to approach this from every angle we can. Funnily enough, we honestly don't get very much information on the Scarlet King from his author, Dr. Clef. We learn of the cult, the Children of the Scarlet King, and the ritual they were attempting causes these women to birth disasters of some form that cause increasing numbers of casualties. We know there is a risk of an XK-class scenario from 231-7 giving birth, but anything past that point is just speculation. It is important to remember that Clef has explicitly stated that SCP-2317 is not the Scarlet King. 2317 was Clef taking a second swipe at the concepts he worked on in 231, and the similarities are supposed to highlight that, but they are not canonically related, at least from an authorial intent perspective. As happens in a large amount of artistic endeavors, the thing you wanted to talk about isn't always the thing your audience is interested in. While Clef was writing about the lengths the Foundation will go to and how monstrous they'll become to fight monsters while hiding that fact from their rank-and-file staff, the general SCP fandom was enamored with this hidden, ancient evil waiting in the wings to come back and end us all. And that's where we hand off the torch to the author who gave us most of what we actually know about the Scarlet King, Jorich. To start off his history, we look to the tale Dust and Blood, which the Villains Wiki actually summed up quite nicely. The Scarlet King was born with the planting of the Tree of Knowledge, called Karak at the time and known to us as the Wanderer's Library. He was the smallest of his siblings, but the only one aware, and it brought him great pain. He decided that existence itself is painful and that he'd have no part in it. As well as destroying existence itself, he started by consuming his siblings and growing stronger on their essence. He vowed to destroy the tree, the creator and creation, and consumed or subjugated all the other gods, naming himself King of the Darkness Below. He declared war on creation itself, one which will not end until the very end of everything. He took Sanaa, one of the gods he subjugated, forcibly as his wife and sired 7 daughters on her. Sanaa died after birthing them, and the king took his 7 daughters as his new brides, sealing them so they would not die as their mother had. 6 of his 7 bride daughters bore him armies of monstrous children called Leviathans. The 7th bore heroes who fought but failed to defeat him. This tale also plants SCP-682 as a child of the 4th bride and gives us a peek into the brother's death, a separate tag on the wiki you can check out that Jorich uses liberally in his Scarlet King canon. For more on them, check out SCP-1440 and the tale Chapter 1, Verse 1 by the author Dematix. We see more of the relationship between the Scarlet King and the brother's death in the tale 3 Short Scenes About Death by Dematix. In this tale, we see that the oldest of the brother's death, All Death, visits the Scarlet King's court annually to deliver a birthday present. Our point of view character points out in this tale that the Scarlet King, terrifying as he is comparatively unimpressive when compared to the All Death. All Death even feels confident enough to call the Scarlet King by his true name, Harem, son of the 3rd Brood. In the end of Jorich's canon, When We Came Home, we see the final war of the Scarlet King in which he snuffs out damn near every single piece of creation, every god and creature and man, before finally being defeated by 7 warriors wielding 7 spears. These warriors would be characters of interest from other corners of SCP lore, such as Isabel Wondermaker, SCP-1440, and Saturn Deer. Reality is restored and the apocalypse has a happy ending. Beyond Jorich's massive contribution to Scarlet King lore, there are also other scattered mentions throughout other works on the site. New Job by Dr. Chandra posits that the child of SCP-231-7 is actually SCP-999, and that the Tickle Monster could be the thing that defeats the Scarlet King with its cognitohazardous happiness. 3 of Tufto's works, 3150, 3514, and 3838, contain mention of Middle Eastern groups dealing with the oncoming threat of the Scarlet King. Twisted Gears gives the Scarlet King a connection to Mr. Red of the Little Misters in his tale SCP-Red. And the tale Fear Alone by DJ Cactus reimagines Procedure 110 Montauk as the act of convincing the Scarlet King that awful things are happening in its name to keep it complacent, while not actually doing anything horrible to the poor girl. This bleeds back into the tale Second Watch by Jorich, where the Scarlet King is described as The king gloried in violence and depravity, calling to it the psychopath and the deviant, who then attempted to summon it and bind it to the world, as the king could not make avatars of its own. Rituals spanned from the proper preparation of a person for consumption, to methods of violation, to the summoning of the king's servants, and all pointed towards the singular purpose of reshaping the world of man in its own image. Ah, and now that I'm back around to Second Watch, it's time to talk about blue whales. In the comments of SCP-231, George explained that he didn't especially like SCP-231 as it is, but joked that because nowhere in the article does it say that 231-1 through 231-7 are humans, that it could be seven sacrificial whales just as easily. This gave the story some much-needed batshit insanity, rather than just being standard horror in his words. When it was pointed out that there was one too many black boxes to accommodate this explanation, Dr. Clef showed up and removed one, hence giving the headcanon his blessing. Due to that joke, you'll notice a lot of whale imagery and references in George's Scarlet King tales. For instance, that his final daughter is named Ahabet, which is a play on Captain Ahab. The Scarlet King, in his words, might as well be a giant cosmic whale entity of destruction. And that's everything. Thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of Sherm's Declassified Skip Survival Guide. If you like what we're doing on the channel, like, share, subscribe, click the bell, and if you really like what's going on around here, hit up the Site42 Patreon or the Site42 store and support the channel that way. You can also join the Site42 Discord server if you want to venture deeper into Site42 itself. See you next time, Foundation staff!